Ahoj, vážení přátelé, vítejte u dalšího dílu Deskofobie. Mým dnešním hostem je Filip Neduk, což je designer, herní designer. A já se teďka přeskočím do angličtiny, protože my spolu nebudeme komunikovat česky, protože Filip je z Chorvatska. Hi, welcome to Deskofobie.
Thanks for having me.
Our pleasure. So the first question for you. You are a game designer and you already have two games out.
Yes.
Which is Goblins and Adrenaline.
Yes.
So the first one was Goblins.
Yeah.
What's the story behind that? Because you was completely unknown in the business, I think.
Yeah.
So what was the story? You as a Croatia designer approach to CG, which is a Czech company.
Yeah.
How's that happen?
So yeah, basically I didn't even know about Essen or anything like before I started. I just started making games because I started playing the modern board games. And I kind of really got hooked and I tried like a lot of stuff. And Goblins was one of the first games that everybody kind of really liked. And so I kind of pushed it forward and I kind of started working for probably the first board game company in Croatia. And they kind of took me to Essen to like help them out. And there I kind of had my prototype of Goblins and I just like tapped Vlad on the shoulder and said, can I show it to you? And he kind of liked it. And then we had a meeting with CG officially. And yeah, then it got published the next year. So it's kind of...
So yeah, that's actually a short story.
It's a short story, but that's how it worked for me.
Yeah. Do you think it's different in these days? Because this is something in the past, right?
No, it's like 7 years ago, I think.
Do you think it changed a little? Or if there is a chance for someone to do basically the same? So have a good game and go...
Yeah, I think it mostly depends on the game. Mm-hmm. I think if you have... there's bigger competition now because of like Kickstarter and it's of the popularity of the medium. But I think if you have a really quality product and go to the right publisher, your chances increase like significantly.
Okay, you said something very interesting to me. Choose the right publisher.
Yeah.
How to do that? How I can change the right publisher for my game? Because my game is awesome and everyone wants to publish it, right?
Oh, it doesn't work that way.
Okay.
you kind of have to kind of see what's out there. Going to Essen is a great thing. So each publisher kind of has their own thing. They're either a Euro publisher, a Meritrash publisher, something in between. That guy, publisher who does a lot of fantasy, a lot of SF, a lot of history games. Each one has their own thing. So some of them do everything. But you kind of, and then you go to those guys that kind of fit your thing you're trying to make. Mechanically, thematically, doesn't matter.
Okay. So, but we are talking about, I already have my game.
Okay.
But I would like to go a little bit further in the past. So how that happened? So I have some ideas, but how I can actually start making some games, some prototypes and everything. Should I just put everything on the paper and start creating prototypes? Or should I just play with ideas in my head for a while? What's your procedure usually?
I think there's no correct answer there. Mm-hmm. I think it's just like up to you. In the end, some people prefer to like have Excel sheets, some just do it on paper, some like make a prototype and do it with a prototype. There's no correct answer. Whatever fits you best, I think, is the way you should go with it. Mm-hmm. And I usually like write a lot and then I make a prototype and then it doesn't work and then I make a new one. And I kind of work slow, but I iterate really a lot. So I kind of learn a lot of stuff. So I have like a lot of information when I do the next. It's kind of... You kind of learn your own game, basically. Mm-hmm. And you kind of have this like huge amount of information that you can like work around with. So you kind of, you did something that's wrong and then you don't have to do it again. So it's less risk, but more work.
Okay. Is it something like snowballing? So I'm putting more stuff in it?
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
Or you think it's a snowballing for a while, but then I have several balls and I need to choose just one.
Yeah, you should decide at some point. I mean, I like the design kind of leads you and players give you feedback and you kind of learn on that. But you kind of have to know what you're trying to accomplish. That's kind of the really important stuff. You have to know how the game looks in the end. There's like this core thing in the game that you kind of really want to be from the start to the finish. You kind of have to have a clear vision of what the end game is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for Adrenaline, it was like capturing the feeling of first-person shooter.
That was actually my next question. How your, especially your games, changed during that procedure of development. So Goblins and Adrenaline. Is it something what you try to achieve from very beginning?
I mean, I had this like idea how I want it to be in the end, but the process kind of swivels around. You kind of try different things, and then you kind of get to a point, either time frame wise, it kind of stops you, or you just kind of decide this is it.
Mm-hmm.
It's good enough, because game is never finished. You can do it like
game is never finished
for 10 years. You have to kind of stop and finish it at some point.
And what's the time schedule for you? Are you able to make the game happen in 1 week, or are you usually working years in one title?
It kind of depends. If I have like an idea, I could do like a really good prototype in like 2-3 days, because mm-hmm. I learned a lot and I'm much faster now, but before it took me a while, like a month. So just something so I can put it on the table to kind of see how it feels. It doesn't have to like work, just to see how it feels with people, the tempo and stuff like that. And if I kind of sense that it's kind of cool, then I'm going to continue to do it mm-hmm. and brush up on the mechanics and stuff.
And the whole procedure from the first idea to the product on the market.
Yeah.
So how long it is?
Oh, I don't know. For Goblins, it was like 3 years from like mm-hmm. the first spark to the like to Essen. And for Adrenaline, it was longer. It was like 5 years, I think.
5 years?
Yeah, yeah. Maybe less. I think 4.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it was. But maybe focusing on that work changed during the time. So you were working a lot in some time, and sometimes you worked just...
Yeah, it's not just on this game. I worked a lot, like on 20 different games. Mm-hmm. But yeah, this kind of crystallizes
mm-hmm.
the one. And you kind of work on it from here and then. You work on other games, play other games. They inspire you to do something else. You kind of learn the mechanics. You have to play a lot of different games, because it's going to spark something in your mind.
Was like. There any research, for example, for Adrenaline? Did you try some first-person
shooter games? Oh, yeah. I played them a lot when
on
I was
computer
younger. Yeah.
Or yeah. As a tabletop game? Because there were some...
I played Frag like mm-hmm. before I even started this, and really didn't like it at all. It was like too much stuff, and uh-huh. I just wanted to like have a streamlined experience of the same thing. It kind of I really like that it's kind of a fast shooting. It's kind of a simple concept, but you can kind of make it.
Do you think it's important to make that kind of research to see what's already on the market, what other publishers do?
Yeah, definitely.
What other designers
Yes, that's really important. Mechanically, you kind of want to take it into a different direction. You don't want to make mm-hmm. it the same game that everybody else makes.
From my point of view, maybe I'm wrong, but just from my point of view, the game design is... part of that design is usually well known. It's something what we know from other games, and maybe it's a part of the games for a very long time. Then you need to add something. Usually you need to add something which is
yeah.
new and unique.
Yeah, yeah.
How big this should be?
That's really interesting. I don't want to be all like statistical. Mm-hmm. I don't know, 30%, 40%.
It's just a question.
But
how you look at it?
You don't kind of... You don't do it that way. You just kind of do it, and it turns out if
mm-hmm.
it's... You kind of see. The more kind of... If it's totally out there, the design, people aren't going to, like, connect to it that well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of hard for them to get into it.
I'm just asking, if I'm young designer,
yeah.
I don't know well about the game designs, and I will say, okay, I need to do something, and I know it's working in... this game very
yeah.
well, so I will borrow it from that game and put it into my own game. Then I need something different, so I will borrow from that game. But at the end, it's not my game design. It's just pieces from other games.
Yeah, but you kind of always try to put your twist on it, because sometimes mm-hmm. it's not going to like fit thematically. There's also the whole thematic aspect that you kind of need to consider. I like some mechanics come out of the theme, some kind of... I mean, I used a great example is in Adrenaline, the player boards are actually area controls and the players are areas that you kind of shoot down. That's kind of a different twist on it. It's still a mechanic that everybody uses, but you kind of need to chase areas around. So it's kind of a different twist.
Mm-hmm. So maybe that can be my other question, but maybe I already know the answer. Was there first the theme or how the game actually works? What was first, egg or chicken?
For Adrenaline, it for came Adrenaline. First, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And actually some of the stuff in the design kind of stayed until the end.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's the how you do range. Because you do range where you're in the room or if you're next to the door, you can see the other room. That was like from the first prototype.
From very first.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's very interesting. Maybe I would like to ask you something a little bit different.
Okay.
We will switch teams because I'm doing that a lot. I'm curious, how big is board gaming in Croatia? Because you are from Croatia, that's what I want to ask you.
Sure.
It's something similar to Czech Republic, or do you think from your point of view, the Croatia is behind or...
I think we are behind because we kind of got into it a little bit late. When I started, it was kind of starting also in Croatia. We have like one shop in the whole country that sells games. Mm-hmm. Now there's like five. It's not that big, but people usually order online because it's kind of expensive. But there is a big growth in the last 5 years, mm-hmm. I would say. There are like coffee shops that play board games and a lot of events. So yeah, I think compared to when I started, that there was nobody, and now a lot of people play, publicly, good. Privately. So yeah, I think it's growing actually.
Maybe more designers that will be from Croatia. Maybe specific topics for the board games. I know there is one prototype which I saw on one Croatia convention. It was Czechy. That was the name. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right.
Okay.
It was about the Czech people coming to vacation. yeah, and a lot of troubles around that. Yeah, that's a very interesting topic for a board game. But maybe something which is really relative to Croatia.
We have like a really rich history. And
yeah, I think so.
Dubrovnik is kind of a great place for a board game setting. I think actually a game got published this year that has the topic, but it's made by an Italian guy.
Mm-hmm. Maybe, that's what I'm curious. If you are from the country with such a rich history, why not to use something from your own history? You are creating fantasy games.
I have like a couple of prototypes.
Uh-huh.
I have actually a game of Dubrovnik also, but this one came out, so I need to change a couple of things.
Okay.
I kind of want to get all the SF and fantasy out of my system first, and then I'll concentrate more on like maybe something, some Euro game or something.
What kind of gamer you are?
I play everything.
You play everything?
Yes.
Okay, so it doesn't matter if it's...
I'm more of a Eurogamer, but I kind of like also the sci-fi theme. That's probably why I kind of mix it all up in my designs.
Are there any games out there on the market which you consider as a brilliant game design? From your point of view, as a game designer, are there any gold things which you think, that would be awesome if I would be able to design this, but this guy did it first?
I really like Terra Mystica a lot. And Gaia Project.
Too.
Yeah.
Me too.
I really like it. I don't think I'm ever going to be that good of a designer to make it. Probably. I don't know. It's kind of... I like the complex games, but I also like simple games like Codenames.
Mm, okay.
Or Trap Words. Kind of really like Trap Words.
It's good to know.
Yeah.
So, if you like all these games, that's a great big variety. You have some light games like Codenames or Trap Words, something very complex games. Do you think it's important for a game designer to play all these games? Or if I'm creating something which is Euro-style, complex game, so I should play all of those, but not anything else?
No, you should play everything.
You should play everything?
Yes, okay. Absolutely. You'll kind of learn a lot of things about like how people act around the table when it's something light, or if they like sit down and think about it when it's like heavy.
Mm-hmm. Do you think there is a point on a time schedule where I should start thinking about creating my own game? should I play 2 years in a row everything on the market, and when I hit 10,000 games or whatever?
That's a really specific question.
Yeah, I know. But do you think maybe there isn't? Maybe it's...
I don't know. I know a couple of designers that like played one game and then they like designed a game, put it on Kickstarter, and it worked for them. Mm-hmm. So there's no rules. That it's not that popular of a game, but I don't know. It worked for them. So I don't know. Yeah. But I would say you're going to have a better game if you like play everything.
Mm-hmm.
You'll learn like different mechanics from each time you play something. Just like write it down and try to like find your way of doing it. It's going to like help you if you have a pool of knowledge of a lot of mechanics, even if they are the same but twisted in a different way. And you can kind of just take, you know how it works in the game. That's the important stuff. And you should make like 10 shitty games, and then you just kind of need to see how they work, especially when you design it. Yeah, that's kind of
okay.
That was like a big lesson for me.
You mentioned Kickstarter 2-3 times. You didn't consider Kickstarter before to publish one of your games?
No. I'm a designer. If you go to Kickstarter, then you're a publisher.
That's true.
Kinda.
That's...
And that doesn't really interest me at all. I like designing stuff.
So you want to focus on...
Yeah, and I think the old school way of publishing is is better.
Maybe in these days it's old school.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people, okay, I have a game, so I will go to the Kickstarter because I will collect more money and everything. Yeah.
People think it's easier, but it's much more work, actually.
At the end. Yeah.
It depends on what you want in the end, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. What do you want? As a designer.
As a designer. I don't know. Continue doing this.
Yeah? You don't have any specific point? I have
games that I've been working on for a long time, and I just like want to polish them and put them out there.
Have you any new games coming soon?
Yeah, probably I do.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. I know, but...
You know.
And I already know we cannot talk about it.
Yes.
But yeah, maybe this is just the information, so we will have something new coming from you.
Yeah.
But recently there was an expansion for the Adrenaline. Maybe do you think there is a space for something more? Maybe another DLC?
We'll see.
Okay.
We'll see how this one goes, and then based on that, who knows?
Okay. So thank you for being here. Thank you for our interview. Thank you very much. I wish you the best with your games, and I'm really looking forward to see something new from you.
Thanks a lot.
A vy se mějte krásně u dalšího dílu. Ahoj.